to be very evenly matched with those 9-to-1 compression motors. Very strict weight limits and carburation limits. O'Neill on the inside, the right 11, 11, right red 11, and then Baldwin, Olsen, and Tony. Like Baldwin in the 84 car may have started to get on the gas a little quick and gotten a little out of shape on the high side, and now he pulls back into place. Lights are out. We could see a start this time around. Also trying to get the behind him. Baldwin goes to the high side. Gimone follows Olsen down the back straightaway, and Randy already puts the Camaro to the outside, trying to make a move. And O'Neill and Olsen going side by side. Randy will try to outbreak him as it turns 3 and 4. Trying to move to the inside and stay out of trouble. O'Neill and Olsen both racing for the lead. And for some of you folks who have not seen these cars in competition, occasionally you will see some sparks fly. Olsen was our leader back to the line, so get everybody sorted out here. Actually, O'Neill would be in the back as well. These guys are deciding that they're going to go 2x2. I think they think it's a complete restart, which is not exactly right. Okay, now we're all set. We should have, I believe, a single final restart with the 17 car, and then the 05, 84, and the 11 car, they seem to think that they ought to be side by side. Maybe somebody out there, the lights just went on and they thought, oh, that's right, we're supposed to be single file here instead of side by side. Now I think they got the program. And I believe that is the correct order. Yep, lights are out. You see the indicator lights in turn 1 and turn 4. And right about now, they'll start to get on the gas. Looking at some of my unofficial tallies, Randy with 5 main event wins so far in 89. I think if you add up his 89 main event wins with his 88 main event wins, I think he's got the all-time record for Superstock main events. I think that's an unofficial one, but I think that's correct. Out of the car, Randy Olsen. Thank you. presenter, Darcy Wandler.